While out running errands one day, a woman spotted a man holding a sign. Homeless and in need of help, this man wasn't asking for money, food, or a job, though. The sign was unlike any that she'd seen before, and it compelled her to help him. What the guy was asking for was, in fact, help for his very special friend. More than two decades ago, Wilma Price had been out grocery shopping when she spotted a group of teens in the parking lot, and what she saw them doing would change her life forever. Yes, it set her on a path to selflessly help those in need and unable to help themselves. Price saw these delinquents kicking a defenseless dog right there in the parking lot. Heartbroken, she picked up the dog and took him home. What's more, she nursed him back to health, and he stayed with her for 10 happy years. It was this incident and the decade-long companionship that followed which inspired Price to set up Mr. K's Pet Shelter, named in honor of her rescued four-legged friend. Since 1995, she's dedicated her life to rescuing and rehousing abandoned dogs in and around Houston, Texas. Running errands in Huntsville, Texas, one day, Price was picking up some meds for her rescue dogs when she spotted a man in the Walmart parking lot. Homeless and in need of help, he was holding a sign that prompted her to strike up a conversation. Unlike the usual signs that Price sees in the hands of the homeless, it didn't say, "I need a beer," or "lost my job," or "need help." The man's sign spoke to her in a way that no other had before. It said, "Dog impound, need help." Price pulled up her car and started talking with the homeless man. The man, named Patrick, had recently been released from jail. Patrick had spent 2 days behind bars for the minor offense of trespassing. For his dog, however, it was a different story. When Patrick was arrested, his dog Franklin was taken to a dog pound. And now Patrick was trying to raise enough money to get his loyal companion back. For an impound fee, a shot, and a health check, the pound wanted $120 to release the dog. It may not sound like a lot to some, but $120 is king's ransom to the unemployed and homeless. Patrick simply didn't have it. It's a lot of money to Price, too, who only had $8. But nevertheless, she was touched by Patrick's situation, that she was determined to help. Price made a couple phone calls, naturally cautious before handing over such a large sum of money to a complete stranger. She called the dog pound, which confirmed that the story was true. Then she called a friend to help out with the money. Upon talking to Patrick some more, Price found out more about him. Age 30, Patrick told her about his circumstances and how he'd ended up in his predicament. And after a few minutes talking, she told him she'd get his dog back, so they headed to the pound. At the pound, Patrick filled in all the paperwork to have his dog Franklin released. Franklin was in good health, remarkable given Patrick's situation. It was clear that despite his circumstances, Patrick took good care of his four-legged friend, carrying his bowl and toys in his backpack. And when man and dog were reunited, it was clear just how much they meant to each other. Price wrote, "The dog was shaking when he came out of the pound. He was so happy, happy to see the man." And Franklin wasn't the only one overcome with emotion. Patrick had tears in his eyes when the dog came out, Price noted. She wrote, "That man loves that dog. On his backpack was the dog's bowl and toys. He's helping the dog against the world." The man was very, very grateful. So grateful, in fact, that Patrick offered Price something in return. Yes, as a sign of gratitude, Patrick offered Price all the money that he'd already collected to go towards the dog's release. But Price refused. More important to her than any kind of reward was to see Patrick and his dog eat well that night. Then Patrick dropped a bombshell. Patrick told Price that he always makes sure the dog is taken care of before himself. And so, although she would return Patrick with Franklin to the parking lot where they'd first met, she was so touched by the pair's bond that she pledged to help him again. In fact, she set up a donations page via her dog shelter website. Anyone wishing to help Patrick and Franklin could pledge money, which Price would pass on to the pair. She also returned to take Patrick to Dallas to arrange an ID to help get him back on his feet. Price said, "I wish I had the money to get the man a room for a week and let him and Franklin regroup, but unfortunately I don't. All I can do is give him his dog and pray that life gives the man a break." In a video posted to Price's Facebook, it's clear that Patrick indeed means the world to his little dog. Left in the car with Price, Franklin soon looks visibly distressed while waiting for Patrick to return, perhaps thinking that he'd been left alone once more, just as he had been at the dog pound. Price says, Sometimes you just have to dig deeper and do what's right in your heart. We've all been in a bad situation in our life, so remember, always pay it forward. You never know who that person might be that you help.